My name's Alex, and I've been traveling the world for about 8 months now. The other day, me and Alex heard about an island off the coast of Belize that has no cars on it, and the only form of transportation is by bike and golf cart. So now here we are a couple days later, heading out on a flight to go check it out. This is a part of a 3-video series. We are going to some ancient ruins that nobody talks about. Summiting Guatemala's most active volcano. It erupts every 15 or 20 minutes. Stay tuned for those videos. And without further ado, let's get on to this one.
6 in the morning, and we are headed off to Belize.
Time has finally come, and we are about to leave. Got about 8 hours of flying today, and then we'll be in Belize. The day started off perfectly. We got on our first flight pretty easily. And the second flight was Denver to Belize, and that's where the problems arose. So we're planning to get to Belize on a standby flight, which means that we're like the last option. So if the flight is full, or in this case, they had issues with weight, we're not allowed to fly. So they said they could only take me or Alex. We obviously chose to stay together. The problem was they kicked us off for weight issues due to ice cubes. Ice cubes that you put in your drink.
I'm not sure what to do exactly.
So we just got a hotel in Denver for the night. And at this point, we thought we were going home for good since we were standby passengers.
Yeah. Should be in Belize right now. Now we're on a subway in Denver.
In our minds, it was gonna be impossible to get here because the next flight was in 6 or 7 days. And that's when I found a new flight.
I'm willing to spend as much as I can to get out there tomorrow. So I just look it up real quick, and on a different airline, $150.
We spent the night, woke up, and we hit the road again. Got ourselves a taxi. $30 USD, and he's gonna drop us off at the water taxi, and that is our last stop to get to our island. Yep,
Key Cocker.
Man, it's raining out. Had to throw our rain covers on. Holy cow. We arrived as the sun was setting on the island, and all of the hostels were completely booked, which means we had to split a hotel, and we immediately hit the road to get a first impression on Key Cocker, and this is a little bit what it looked like.
Static selected.
Tonight was a very good first night in Key Cocker. Now, I'm gonna go to bed. So it is now the morning here in Belize, and the weather is pretty cruddy today, but that's all right, because we have like an hour of decent weather right now before the rain starts, so
Let's do this.
This yellow building behind me is literally their police station for this whole island. All right, we're here with Alan. Yeah. Say what's up.
Born Belizean, 100% to the bone.
We're gonna go see the local breakfast spot.
All right.
And get some grub.
Yeah, remember, yeah. Life is a circle, no squares, no triangles. Yeah, I was raised up in San Pedro, Sin City. And I came over here because
How long? Yeah.
I live here for 5 years now.
5 years, man.
Yeah.
My boy Alan here is going to camp on an island with some crocodiles in a couple days
for
in a lagoon.
Alone.
With swamp water up to his waist.
Alone. That's, for 2 weeks.
Respect. We came here. What's this place called?
Duffy Lobster.
We're about to grub out, so. So we have just checked out and said goodbye to our friend Alan. The sense of community in this place is unlike any place I've been before. Everyone is overly kind. This is an island of about 4,000 people, Alan said, and they all seem like one big family. I mean, everyone knows each other. Something pretty special compared to a lot of places in the world.
After just being there 24 hours, it became pretty evident to us that the people make this a very special place. We spent our time there with some of the most kind-hearted and warm people. It's always a pleasure to meet the new people out on the road. Everyone has something they could teach you, and whether that's from their life experience or just the stories they're telling you, there's always something to be learned.
Literally walk into our hostel, found some guys climbing a coconut tree.
I'm gonna try again.
Chopping her up. Pretty good. Cheers,
bro,
my friend.
Coconut, man. This is a Belize style.
My brother is in the tree.
Yeah.
Throwing down the nuts. Hey. Uh
huh. Out of the same coconut,
my brother
made
a spoon.
And this is how we do it.
I'm eating pretty key talker.
There's just cats that run around.
Yeah.
All around here.
Yeah. Big man, come.
Go ahead. We're out here on Key Cocker, and
no, those guys, they do that to you guys because you guys are with me.
Oh,
they
really?
Get you guys with a little four.
Yeah.
And those guys be like, I was always trying to sell you guys junk.
If you're wondering what happened there, our homie Cameron was taking us on a walk through the local side of the island, and that's when the cops stopped us for virtually no reason at all. We continued on with our walk, and along the way we saw so many cool things, proving how truly special this island is. And tomorrow we got invited to go spearfishing, so we just wrapped up and called it a night.
Come on up. How's it going, man?
Yeah, man, this is Cameron, man. This is Alex, man. He's going in the water, man.
Hell yeah, man.
The island's not very wide at all, so everyone pilgrims over to the west side for sunset. The people are all hanging out, playing sports, and enjoying the final moments of the setting sun. Maybe it's the next day here and we got our fish cooked up and ready to go. That's the homie. Take a bite, Alex, of his head.
Of the eye. Go for the eye.
I'm not.
We wrapped up eating our fish right off of the bone. And just like that, our time in Key Cocker had come to an end. To think that we almost didn't make our flight and almost didn't get to experience all these beautiful things is wild to me. The beauty in travel has always come from the people you meet and the new experiences you have, not the prettiest views or the most expensive things, as a matter of fact. Key Cocker is just a dot in the world, and if I had to tell the story of it, it would be a kind one.
one where the people welcome you as soon as you get off the boat and make you feel like family. I just want to thank you guys for tuning in. This is my first big style project. I've been filming this video over a course of 3 to 4 weeks now. I'm so glad to see how it came out. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And with that being said, look out for the next video. Peace.